Inside the organs of the plant are tissues that contain specialized cells to help with the functioning of the plant. Plants have a skin, or epidermis, that serves a similar purpose as our skin does. It is to protect the internal parts of a plant from the external environment. The surface of the plant may have many features that relate to the epidermal tissue. Plant hairs, spines, or prickles extend from the epidermal cells. These hairs may offer plant protection from munching herbivores or make it difficult for insects or fungal spores to get on the plant's surface. The epidermis may also be entirely smooth, like a rain jacket, to help moisture roll off. The epidermis also exudes the cuticle, a waxy coating to further protect the plant from the external environment. Plants grown in cushy indoor environments tend not to develop a thick cuticle, hence the reason they may have problems when suddenly moved outdoors. Embedded in the epidermis are stomata, pores in the surface of the leaves. These holes allow for an exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide, evaporated water, and other gases between the inside of the leaf and the external environment. They can inadvertently be used by some diseases to get into the plants as well. Flanking the stomata are pairs of guard cells. Using the guard cells, the plant can open and close these pores as it responds to the environment to prevent the plant from drying out on really hot days. Enclosed under the epidermal tissues, we find the ground tissue and the vascular tissue. Vascular tissue is the plumbing of the plant. It's continuous from the roots, through the stems, into the leaves or flowers. Vascular tissue is made of two cell types, the xylem and the phloem. The xylem cells function to move water from the roots up to the leaves. The phloem cells move the sugar produced in the leaves to where it's needed in the plant, or where it can be stored for later use. The vascular tissues of monocots and dicots are arranged differently. In monocots, our grass-like plants, the vascular tissue is arranged in bundles in the stem. In dicots, the vascular tissues tend to be arranged in more or less a circular pattern, with the phloem to the outside of the stem and xylem to the inside. With woody plants, the arrangement of tissues is more organized. The cambium creates phloem to the outside, under the bark, and xylem to the inside. Each year, creating a new ring of growth we can count. Knowing a bit about the vascular arrangement helps you understand how water, nutrients, and sugar moves in the plant. Also, understanding vascular tissues will help you understand other important issues such as wilt diseases, stem-boring insects, and girdling roots. Ground tissue refers to everything else that's inside the plant that's not epidermal tissue, that's not vascular tissue. This includes cortex cells in the root that help filter pollutants from the water the plant is absorbing. These would also be cells designed to perform photosynthesis in the leaves, or pith cells inside herbaceous stems that give the plant overall support. The building blocks of all these tissues are the plant cells, and like everything else, they can be highly variable and specialized. Most plant cells have some common characteristics. First, there's a nucleus. In the nucleus of the cell is all the genetic information about the plant. A very unique feature with many plants is they will have the ability to access that information all through their lives. Let's explain this with a contrasting example. In humans, we are developing in utero. Our cells start off as blank cells, unspecified stem cells, that then turn into bone cells, or the cells of our cornea, or liver cells, or muscle cells. And once an eyeball cell, always an eyeball cell. In plants, cells also start off as undifferentiated as they are created by the meristems. When exposed to hormones in the environment, these generic cells become xylem cells or phloem cells or guard cells for stoma or pith or cortex cells or any number of other types of cells in the plant's body. What's different about plants and humans is that many plants retain the ability of those differentiated cells to turn into something else. We call these cells totipotent. Under certain circumstances, Cells in the leaf of the plant can turn into roots. Cells along the stem can change into meristems and grow new shoots. Severed roots may reform stems and leaves and regrow a whole new plant. It is this ability for plant cells to always access the genetic material and turn into something else that allows us to do the cuttings and propagate plants the way that we do. Plant cells in leaves, some stems, and a few roots contain chloroplasts. Inside the chloroplast is a pigment called chlorophyll, and this is the site of photosynthesis, the conversion of carbon dioxide into sugars using light energy. Floating elsewhere in the cell is the mitochondria. The mitochondria is called the powerhouse of the cell, and it's responsible for breaking sugars apart and releasing energy, which is the opposite of what the chloroplast does. The energy released is what helps keep plants alive and growing. Mitochondria are found in almost all plant cells. Encapsulating all the innards of the cell is the membrane, which is then surrounded by a cell wall. The cell wall is a unique feature to plant cells. The cell wall is composed of cellulose, lignin, and other substances that, in the plant's entirety, give it strength and protection. Cellulose requires special enzymes in order for it to break down, an enzyme found in some animals' guts and not others. That's why cows can eat grass and we can't. And lignin is what makes our woody plants woody. You've now been introduced to the major organs and tissues of the plants, and several important features within plant cells. You'll hear these parts referenced again and again as you continue your study in the Master Gardener program. Your skills with plant anatomy will improve as you learn how these parts interact with the environment, play a role in disease formation and prevention, or can be manipulated during plant propagation to make more plants.